This is only the beginning of congressional scrutiny over the IRS's actions. Next week, the head of the department that approves tax-exempt status, Lois Lerner, will testify before the House Oversight Committee. It appears she knew about the targeting almost from the beginning in 2010, but who else knew? Our Aaron McPike has been taking a closer look at this. Aaron?
Well, Jake, Lois Lerner is becoming more of an issue here because we now know that her signature was on at least one document to a Tea Party group asking for more information over a year ago. So now the question has become, did she not know what she was approving?
After resignations and a contentious hearing on Capitol Hill, there's growing confusion over who knew what and when during the multiple years the IRS was targeting Tea Party groups. Lois Lerner, who heads up the Cincinnati IRS office that oversees tax-exempt organizations, apologized last week after admitting that her division delayed processing applications for hundreds of Tea Party groups. But now the Richmond Tea Party is charging that Lerner is part of the scheme she's trying to fix.
We found what we think is kind of a smoking gun.
Larry Nordvig runs the Richmond group that first filed for tax-exempt status in December of 2009. The IRS sent Nordvig's group two more requests for information over the next 25 months. Lerner's signature is on one of those letters from March of 2012.
The 55 questions are the ones that were extremely intrusive. For example, they wanted to know all our donors' names. They wanted to know whether they'd run for political office, whether they were going to run for political office. They wanted pictures of our web pages with member login personal pages that would have revealed who our membership people were, and other things like that. So she definitely had to know what level of questioning was going on during this time.
But acting IRS Commissioner Steve Miller, who resigned this week, defended Lerner this morning.
First, you should know, while her signature is on there, her signature is on 70,000 applications. So let's not personalize this one to Ms. Lerner. In 2011, June or July, whatever it was, she handled and fixed the list issue. The cases were still in development. The cases needed to be in development. There were issues. We just did a remarkably bad time of it.
That kind of explanation isn't good enough for Nordvig.
I don't think many people believe that this was just a couple of rogue workers at a cubicle. But all that notwithstanding, when you put your signature on a piece of paper, whether it's a stamped, a robo-signature, or your own hand, that's your signature on that paper, and you have to own that. So, you know, as far as we're concerned, that's Ms. Lerner's signature on there.
Nordvig's group was approved last year, and he and some Tea Party activists are encouraged by President Obama's actions so far.
I promise the American people this investigation has just begun. Hearing adjourned.
But they won't be satisfied until they get all the answers.
Now, Jake, Larry Nordvig and some of my Republican sources have said to me that they're actually pretty satisfied with how President Obama has responded over the past week, but there are still these burning questions about how high up the food chain this went.
And a long history in this country of presidents using the IRS for political muscle, so that's why a lot of Americans are so suspicious. Aaron McPike, thank you so much.